You've been seen re-entering a forbidden...
It's hot in here. Soldier. Onward. By your command. We do what we must. I think I could go another round.
Can't give up, not now.
Thank you. forever, pal.
Wow.
wonder what the next move is.
Tree is plagued by pestilence, yet refuses to die. The goddess Shantia wishes me to save it. I can feel it.
Getting to the mansion's faded exterior, you see the faintest outline of a door, an entrance designed to provide the utmost discretion. Whatever lies behind the door, it guards such secrets closely. It will not reveal them to just anyone. Nothing responds within. It is silent as... Whatever lies behind the door, nothing responds with...
Attention!
Get into the door. You sense it waits for the right words. It requires permission to open. Whatever this door is waiting to hear, it is not that the door does not stir. It will not answer. Lord Gortash's name opens many doors, but it does not. Nothing responds within.
A long way.
Get going.
Need of you. pack.
You do not have an appointment. What possible reason could you have to enter the presence of Mr. Carrion? That depends on what torments you. Love, vengeance, regret. The dead can be put to all sorts of purposes. In the hands of one adept at their manipulation. I am a spirit medium. One who wanders the hazy boundaries of mortality, bearing the intentions of the living and the knowledge of the dead. You do not possess the aptitude to attempt such a journey. Nor are you the caliber of client I would usually offer to escort. My story has been eternities in the making. Were I to recount it, you would return to dust before I finish the first sentence. As for why I chose this place as my home, it is a city rife with anguish, rippling with disturbed spiritual energy. The people here required a reassuring hand to navigate such waters, and so I offered mine. If that is the sum of your curiosity, then I'm afraid we have nothing more to discuss. In this life, at least. Unless, of course, you are looking for a job. Some spiritual materials, though not much within reach of your purse, I fear. Again, my client list is full, and you are not on it. Yes. My spirits stir. They think you might be capable. Very well. You may help me with a small matter. I have an assistant, Thrumbo. A conduit I use to maintain my connections with the ethereal plane. Unfortunately, he has deserted his duties. He has not gone far, but given the sensitivity of his nature, I would prefer that he is not free to roam the city. Return Thrumbo's body to me, and I will see that you are suitably compensated. It's quite simple. He resented having to work for a living. The undead can be rather lazy in that regard. He was always a simple, contented creature, a beggar to the bone. Perhaps he has forgotten how ungenerous the world can be, or simply prefers to live in the gutter. If he does not value the gift I gave in reanimating that wretched flesh of his, then I will take it back. It is my property, not his. Had I thought you were the type to shout his name from the rooftops, I would never have offered you the job. Thrumbo is not alone in his ingratitude. He has led others in my service astray. Three of them, beggars and zombies alike. The others lack even Thrombo's modicum of intelligence. It should be no great task to wring his location from one of them. Do not think on it too long. Lest my offer be rescinded. You carry strange tidings. Strange indeed.
Jahira, do you like to... That is, what do you like to do?
As in... Hobbies? Oh, well...
I'm just picturing you
I like to
hot,
play
so
music.
Hard, the strings snap. Try not to shriek. what do you play?
Mostly the same children's rhyme. The battered whistle of tin. I do not get a lot of time to practice.
Flowers.
Spare me the sad eyes, girl. Not every daily deed is worthy of song. Certainly none